Have you ever imagined what it's like to be the bull in the china shop? It might sound like great fun, but that's actually my life day to day. Imagine having to use your full concentration to do something as simple as manipulate something with your hands or walk through a room.
My name's Andy, and I'm a DJ and producer. I'm also dyspraxic. Today I'm going to tell you what that means and how that affects my music.
So Andy, what is dyspraxia?
Okay, essentially dyspraxia, it's similar to dyslexia,
right,
except it affects physical coordination rather than the ability to read and process words. So I can actually read perfectly well, but navigating, say, in a busy room is incredibly difficult for me.
So Andy, what is it actually like having dyspraxia?
Well, basically, it's a kind of clinical clumsiness. So I have to think very, very hard about where my body is when I move through a space. So, you know, as a child, I was terrified of china shops, and I still actually get slightly uneasy around sort of porcelain knickknacks and things like that.
Okay, how has this affected your studies over the years?
Well, I also have terrible handwriting, and sort of in the bad old days before they used to sort of really be on diagnosing this sort of thing, it generally is considered that I was a bit dim. Mm-hmm. But it really helped me. I remember actually until you had good enough handwriting, you weren't allowed a fountain pen, and you had to use this terrible thing called a barrel smooth writer.
Right.
You know, barrel pens?
Yes.
Oh, and it was, you know, chicken scratches in the dirt.
Right.
Bloody terrible.
And how would you say dyspraxia affects your music?
Well, I think it drove me into electronic music, because it has nothing to do with my body. I mean, if I were playing a guitar, you know, each individual note involves my complete attention. You know, just navigating around, say, a china shop, you know, takes my complete attention. So electronic music, it has everything to do with your mind and nothing to do with your body. I mean, you have complete control. I mean, what a guitarist would do by wiggling their finger slightly, I do on a computer by modulating five or six effects separately.
So Andy, what's your favourite genre of music at the moment?
Well, at the moment, I'm playing mainly dubstep and more sort of breakbeat, garagey kind of sounds. Although the term genre is kind of limiting, I think. I mean, I tend to chop and change between styles through a night. You know, I don't think you can really stick to one beat for an entire evening. You know, people don't really have the attention span for it these days, and it's a lot more interesting.
Yeah. And where do you see yourself going after your studies are finished?
Well, I have got several projects on the go. I DJ, as you can see. I also run a radio site with my friend. And we also have a sound system for doing private parties and so forth. I'm sorry, I've got a ladybug.
So what things do you do, what ways do you cope with the challenges of dyspraxia?
Well, a lot of things. I found that playing a lot of video games as a kid, basically, that was practicing spatial coordination, you know, in isolation, almost, you know, without actually having to go around and jump on platforms myself. Right, I'm just going to give you guys a brief demonstration of what I can do, despite being dyspraxic. Right, here we go.
Have you ever imagined what it's like to be the bull in the china shop? It might sound like great fun, but that's actually my life day to day.